Greetings, I am Lies and I use she, her.
And I am Scandal and I use they, them.
And let's play a game together. Let's doodle a game together. Let's find out how much of this world we create from basically whatever's conceptualized in our mind at the time and how much it just takes on a life of its own. Because yes, we're about to like watch a movie and we only drew one vague scene of it. And next time, I swear, I will convince myself to go outside the borders and do it!
We can do it! Hi.
Falcor looks happy at least, so we're okay.
Movie sounds.
Whoa.
Movie sounds continue.
The music supports the movie sounds. Oh! What a card! That nothing is hilarious! Oh. No, don't do it! Don't leave your horse behind! I mean, don't lose faith, Artex! Screams that Artex must live.
A movie sounds.
Ooh, whoa. Didn't see that coming! Mind blown.
Artex died.
You can remake the entire world!
And the movie finally ended. And as the credits rolled, we realized we had been holding hands the whole time, somehow.
Even though...
We pulled away, it was a little crispy and crinkly. As suddenly, once looking at each other, just once though, because dear God, I don't think that you have enough dimensions for me to be able to look at you twice. Mm-hmm. You are, after all, a drawing on a piece of paper.
Additionally, bro, we didn't draw you hands, so I don't know what we were holding.
I was holding hair.
I was holding the edge of your shirt.
Poink!
Poink!
The collar that's color. Really popped.
Yes.
Hi.
Oh. Sorry.
Wow.
Wow, that was some Academy Award material right there.
Did actually? The Neverending Story?
Oh, wait, Academy Award?
I'm actually, hang on.
We're gonna check. I know it was popular, but I don't know if it won at awards. Neverending Story, Academy Award. We're gonna find it. We're gonna check Neverending Story, Academy Award, because maybe if it was, that'd be freaking hilarious.
Academy Award.
Award.
Award. Never ending bow. Who knows? I mean.
Story. Awards? No.
I'm not seeing anything.
I don't know if it ever won any awards at all, maybe.
It might have not.
Oh, and the wiki usually they have like awards and things.
Yeah, that's what I'm looking.
Hang on, we're doing a
research. Distributed, Running Light, Countries, Language, Budget, Box Office. Nope.
None. Plotcast.
A plot, cast, production, release, popular culture, possible remake.
Oh, God.
Which they haven't done.
Yep, looks like there are no awards at all. So, Sketchy thinks it's peak movieing. However,
with
Sketchy
a single frame.
However, Sketchy has never seen any movies
at all.
So, yeah.
Academy Award winning material right there. We should have done Parasite and just pissed off more white people. That was the
Titanic
one that we needed to get from the library.
That's the one.
That's the one.
That's the one.
That's
See,
the one.
That's what it was. I knew there was another one.
Sorry, we were talking earlier about going, hey, we should watch just a couple of these movies because we thought about buying them. And then we haven't actually seen them yet.
Yep.
And right. I was like, I'm willing to take the risk. My friend was like, I don't want it. I'm like, okay.
I don't want to buy a thing. Like, and I'm like, you could totally buy it. And they're like, but I would like to, you know, share it with you. And I'm like, then I got to watch it first.
Got to see it first. Got to find out. All right.
All right.
And libraries are really good for that. So if you live in the United States, please support your local library. They are fantastic for that.
Check
sort of
movies out from them. Order movies from them. Use Prospector to get movies. Find
yes,
movies.
Dear God.
I can't believe.
That, oh, yeah.
You made that.
I gently fold away my second pair of hands. Yes. Neither can I.
So, what did you think? What was your favorite part?
The one frame. The comedy, the drama, the action when it was over with. All right, so since it was your movie, what was your favorite part of The Neverending Story?
I liked the visual design and the fantasy elements.
Oh, well, shit, that's not an option.
It's not. So, the drama, because I enjoyed the story as a whole.
Honestly, like, I'd love that we'd actually go, we're gonna go watch a drama, and a drama is literally just a series of events of things that happen. It doesn't necessarily mean that it's a drama until you go, this is the genre of drama.
Mm-hmm. It's true.
But it's
anyway,
like,
so
yeah.
In this case, it would be the drama, because the drama is the story.
Yeah. But and in this case, if it's comedy, drama, or action, that is like the...
I know that's the genre, but it's none of those drama genres, and it wouldn't specifically be when it was over with because the movie wasn't bad, so I'm telling you, that's my answer, and you can take it or leave it.
No, that's fine. I'm just like, oh. Mm-hmm. I'm disappointed how few responses there are there. Honestly, I'm really surprised. I like the part where everyone learned a valuable life lesson.
You mean where specifically our boy, whatever his name was.
I don't remember.
Learned
Hero
a valuable
child.
Life lesson so he could, you know, go through the gate
of
Mirror Gate or whatever.
Yeah, that one. It's fine. God, honestly, like, the design on that movie really was really good. I swear to God, I was fascinated by the Sphinxes as a child because they looked cool as hell.
They really did.
And, like, Falcor was also best boy.
Yeah, Falcor was best boy.
It was true.
Mm-hmm. Wow. That's my favorite part, too, because I'm made out of you. I mean, I like movies. I mean, I've only seen the one, but you must be lucky to be able to see them so often in your world.
Yeah. But I feel even luckier being here, because honestly, like, all that pressure of going out and, like, at least currently right now there's a pandemic and not everybody really wants to wear their mask. It's really stressful. I mean, wait, what?
There's no diseases in here.
There's no diseases in here, and I don't have to worry about really being
theoretically
hungry.
Whatever I want if I wanted to eat. I have a perfect bed, and I can really draw
a perfect food.
Anything I feel like having, and there's no requirements of me. Whoops.
Ooh, careful.
Sorry,
with that.
Bumped the mic. I say.
So honestly.
Being here.
Luckier. Being here.
Oh? Why is that?
Because I'm here with you.
I guess?
A sketchy blushed and then drew closer, holding my hand in theirs.
Is that so?
I guess.
Yeah.
Sketchy suddenly gave me a small peck on the cheek before pulling away, and I still don't know what hands we are holding, but there we are.
But there they are. Well... good. The goodiest.
The dates continued throughout the coming weeks. More movies, more dinners, etc. Each time we grew a little closer.
Because
I drew more lines to try to expand Sketchy when they weren't looking. Because the thing is there's not really a person here.
Sketchy could keep becoming more of an actual person. And also to add more of my thoughts to their creation process to have more interaction and less volatility. To mature the character, as
yes, absolutely. Yep. Mm.
Developing my own OC, it's fine.
That's what I'm doing. I'm giving them a tragic backstory. Watch this. As the weeks turned into months, I came to realize that I didn't want to leave this place. There was no future I could imagine that didn't involve Sketchy. Which is to say, didn't involve art. And also didn't involve basically having a thing that I drew in order to validate myself. Perfect way that I was looking for, I'm assuming, because me personally, as the person who's playing this character, I'd be like, wow, Sketchy is deeply unappealing. Like, the character that they have created wasn't... I'm like, if there is the implication that that is what your character was actually thinking, and they are created basically based off of the bits of you that you were thinking about at the time, or basically things that picked up or that you inserted into them without realizing it, that's that character's idea of a good time, and I don't know if I can agree with that.
I mean, I don't connect to it at all, really. I was like, there's also a level of the game just going, what you're having here is a no options, no holds barred, it is a romance, you are feeling the romance. But for me, I'm also like, if you're in a world where you kind of refuse to draw any other people at all, and you don't want to create more of a world until it's asked or demanded of you. This person doesn't seem like they like to draw.
At
or
all.
Or inspired to draw or interested in drawing. It just seems like, in the way that most people have picked up and doodled something during their life, that's all they've done. I say, and then you have this experience of going, I've got this being or concept that will cater to my every desire, and I can put us in any situation we want, and is literally created to be interested in me. So... I also, in that way, being in the sketchbook, may be compelled to be interested in them because that's the context of this graphic and or physical story.
Yeah, how much did it actually alter you to get slid into this world, actually?
To become sketchbook compatible.
Yes.
Because that's a question I have.
I had to let Sketchy know how I felt, I guess, since I have feelings.
Sketchy, touch me so you know how I feel.
Wow, your graphite's beautiful today.
You feel smooth.
You feel like a unibulb.
Oh, God.
Wow, you're really inky today.
Isn't it beautiful today?
Anywhere is beautiful so long as you were there.
Oh, stop it. So, why did you want to come here today?
You can do this, I thought to myself as I tried to dislodge the frog in my throat. I don't know why I drew it there, but I definitely had to pull it out.
Croak.
That is a really bad looking frog. Sketchy, I love you.
Oh.
More than love you. In fact, I've been thinking about it for a while, and I don't think I ever want you out of my life. I'm willing to stay here forever, Sketchy, if...
Go on.
Sketchy, will you marry me and give me every fantasy that I have ever wanted? Actually, that was a discussion that you and I kind of vaguely had, and I, just today, where I was kind of like, I find it interesting in a lot of stories that it seems like the real kind of love that a lot of people want is they want to go or be removed from the situation that they're in and also be with that person slash character. If they're actually having a them experience, they don't want to be in their own life.
You don't want your fictional desirable boy to join you in your real life drama.
Uh-huh.
And I say loosely here, with your bills and with your health and with your family and your external stressors and your schedule, you want to be removed from all those things and just be able to indulge in an experience of being wanted and loved and exposed to new non-stressful things.
And to me, in some ways, it almost sounds like what a lot of people look for is just basically all I want to do is leave where I am. Mm. It's not even necessarily going like, and that's the thing I've wondered sometimes, like, that, like, if it, is it, like, that situation where you go, does this person actually love me? Well, because if they truly loved me, they would take me away.
They would stop the hurt that's happening to me, which is a result of my environment.
Yes.
And therefore remove me from my environment.
Yes, and now you've got a completely different environment with this person that we are the two people in the trench coat.
And again, if you have this experience where the character, when they said, hey, I've had a lovely summer by myself doing things alone, that can be considered depression activities, even though some people genuinely just like them and have a good time with them.
Right.
And they were basically, and our MC was, or our me, if you will.
Right.
It's not an MC, it's an ME.
It's an ME.
I was going to say,
multiple entities.
Was basically nice. Nice. Yes. High five.
These high fives are really bad, but that's
it's okay, we get it. I was going to say, then, and you actually were, like, basically trying to glamorize your isolated, lonely, stressful life and going, I really am hiding from the world because what I have is social anxiety and discomfort and lack of connection and stuff like that, then this could be amazing because you go, I literally got away from that situation and other things. And there also could be indicators thematically of going, you know, you made a perfect bed for yourself. That was the only priority in your house.
Yeah.
Maybe you have a lot of trouble sleeping. Maybe you have pain and comfort, that kind of thing.
Right.
Maybe you can't stay asleep for a long time and or whatever, and that's gone here.
Yeah. Honestly,
so
that sounds great.
The appeal of this place would be huge if, in fact, your life actually was stressful and uncomfortable, especially if you weren't lonely, and if you're allowed to have unlimited access to this person, then not lonely.
Yeah.
Not complexly stimulated, but certainly short-term, not at all lonely.
Yeah. Will you marry me?
Draw
an engagement ring!
Well, I believe it's your turn to draw.
Is it actually my turn?
I don't know, we can go every other time, because I did the movie at least.
You did that? Well, it was 2 and 2, right? So.
Yeah, but I think it's okay to just switch back and forth.
Sure, we could do that, that's fine.
Draw the engagement ring, my friend.
Oh my god.
You get to do it. What kind of an engagement ring would ME, the multiple entities, or create?
No.
Here, I think we're going to
need to move
this.
Never-ending store. I don't want to move that,
though. That's what I mean. This is what you're hitting.
Well, no. But if
there,
I come to...
back there.
I'm trying
nope.
to...
You up higher.
It's because I can't fit my hand on here. I
oh,
don't
no.
draw like that. I don't think
Hold
you
on. I think we're going to need to move the microphone.
No, if... Don't do it. You can't move it any further.
Okay. Then, there's more space over here.
Aha!
Aha, hang on. We have cords and wires we have to deal with here.
All right, here we go. It
would be a thing. All right.
So,
Can do it. We will figure out the technical limitations.
I hope. I'm like, I was not prepared to draw a circle today.
Okay,
so we're gonna
what
go.
What if it's not a circle?
Also, I've seen some people actually do like engagement necklaces, but it has to be
still
a ring because this is what's required in the story.
It does.
Nah.
But it doesn't say what kind of engagement ring.
Alright, we go like this.
I love this.
I'm so glad you love it because I think it's poor as hell.
It's okay. I mean, have you seen our love interests?
Somebody out there. What? They're beautiful!
Sketchy,
be nice, Sketchy!
Excuse you!
Right, I'm still just distressed about how thick the lines are, to be honest. Like, you can't draw hardly any detail. Honestly, you could go huge with the ring if you wanted to as well, which would be very entertaining.
I was kind of thinking about doing it, but then I was like, eh, it's fine.
It is fine. Oh, look at this perspective and all of it.
Whoops.
I was like, I think I distracted my friend. Here we go.
Okay.
All right. And
also,
you have to switch back to the
huge.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Yeah, I was like, you're going to lose your whole ring. Your entire ring will be consumed.
Consumed.
Oh, you're doing a double ring.
Doing a double ring?
Or a spiral ring? Or I don't know. I'm trying to figure it all out.
I'm not. Wow.
It's a rose, isn't it?
I have no idea.
It's a freaking rose. I'm gonna do it. It's a rose.
Sure, why not?
That's amazing. All right, well, hopefully his...
There's no genders
in here. Hopefully Sketchy's sense...
I keep getting really distracted. You keep saying his.
I know. I'm sorry. I feel the experience in this game too hard. It's more of the inspiration of the character you chose.
I appreciate that, but that's not the character that I chose.
Oh, my bad. Anyway, I was like... Hopefully Sketchy does not have the same kind of sensibilities as Claire does. Of going, oh, you created a fashion thing? It's shit.
Yeah, I really honestly didn't appreciate that. I was
like,
really surprised.
The only cuss word in this game is to diss on something we created.
Thanks.
That Claire demanded we create.
Uh-huh, that needed to be there. And then you're like, wow, okay.
Oh my. That's a big ring. Where do you want me to put it?
I don't know, because you literally are only a headshot.
Big, very pretty ring.
Over your head, it's a tiara.
Yes, tiara.
Yes, tiara.
Tiara is a ring. You can engage with a tiara. I don't know what to say.
Yes? My heart began to tremble.
I mean, if you, are you...
Am I what?
Oh, heck. Why not? Yes. Yes, I will.
I slid the ring on the Sketchy's head.
Yes.
Just on the head. And we embraced. I couldn't believe it. This was real. I was getting married. I'm only 19.
Were we
19? We just got out of high school.
I thought we were still in
high school.
No,
it says we're 18.
Of high school.
I thought it was at least we're 18 and that's it.
But we don't consider it summer vacation if you've already graduated, so we still have one more year.
Oh, shit.
Because
so
you don't
17?
Say, I'm on summer vacation if you've already graduated.
What is... Okay, this person had weird thing. I don't know. Maybe they missed some school and they need to go back for
some... Some people, depending on when their birthday is and, yeah, how things roll, they can be 18 in their last year of high school.
Oh, no.
Sure.
I know that.
Mm-hmm.
I was getting married. Absolutely. Wow.
Wow.
It was real. Wow.
Do we have to draw a wedding dress?
I need to put a tiara. The day had come. I was sweating like a maniac in my nervously doodled tuxedo. Why am I wearing a tuxedo? I wanted to wear my trench coat. My raincoat.
Rain trench.
I was starting to sweat. Oh, shit. Quickly, I erased the smeared lines and hastily redrew them back on. You are now a picture.
You can redraw yourself.
Oh.
All right, everyone. Remember that meme for draw yourself
idealized? I separated from everyone else. I actually loved a bunch of people who responded by drawing themselves as, like, nameless entities. Mm-hmm. Fungus. Mm-hmm. You know, shoes.
Yep.
They were like, fuck you.
Yep. Idealized.
You can do this. You've prepared for this day. No, I haven't, but just relax.
Okay, I do have to cover this just really quick, going, if you can redraw yourself and or draw yourself at all, and this character has never engaged with it in any way they're willing to share with us, which we're not getting very much exposure to, you know, me's life,
yeah.
Which is supposedly our life experience. But that is a solid experience of going, have you been doing this? You seemed super comfortable with the I erased the sweat in my hastily doodled tuxedo.
Right?
So did you basically just go, Claire, fuck off. My clothes that I make are brilliant, and I'm going to make more of them now that you've told me to do it, and I don't care what your opinion is.
Right?
No! Move it over there! Do it!
Hey, dear. Everything okay?
Yes! No! I don't know! Move it over there, I said! There! Yes, there! Could you just draw it in the right place, darling? Please.
Sure. Did I draw people? This now begs the question, what have I been drawing?
An entire wedding reception and wedding party and decorations and wedding planner for the wedding.
For somebody who really strongly dislikes art at this point, I'm really surprised at how much I've been drawing.
Well, I asked you to draw it all because we needed all of it. God damn these decorators! Anyway, yes. Yes, everything's fine. I'm just a little nervous is all.
It's okay. I'm too. This might be a potential for a good moment to go, are these some red flags that I am concerned about if I never seek to have a communicative, open relationship where, hey, by the way, we should have some standards and some expectations going, hi, when you scream, it frightens me. There's literally a meteor in the sky. Honey, can we not do that?
Can we maybe not?
Can we not? Like, because actually, that's the thing that I remember somebody talking about is going, like, if you ever want to, like, get to know someone, they say that watch them while they're under stress, basically, something that deeply upsets them. But also, as somebody else countered, which I agree with, is going, like, there is that, but there is also then going, see also how they respond then to you, conveying to them, that frightened me, or I felt like this when you did that, and put in whatever you felt like, and then go, hey, could we do something else? Yeah. And then seeing then how they respond to that. Because if their response is to basically go, oh, yeah, and then they basically ignore it, or they go, oh no, it's changed, and they don't do anything, or they don't try to work on it, or they go, or they basically agree to something, and then they just ignore it, or if they actually try to make active changes, or they brush it off, like, that will also tell you then even more than just them screaming, and then you just going, well, I'm uncomfortable, I will walk away without engaging, because sometimes why people continue these patterns of behavior is because other people haven't interacted with them, and they don't know that it's actually affecting anyone else at all.
And sometimes that's just who they are, and they really do go, what? No, it's fine. Oh, I wasn't a big deal. That's just how I am.
Oh, it's changed. No, I changed yesterday. I swear.
Or not even that one. Just the, this is fine. Yeah. The standard is fine. And that's just how I am.
Oh, yeah.
And it's fine. It's not scary. I was scared. It's not scary.
It's not. Why would I ever hurt
anyway, you? Anyway, so those are really good things to have in a relationship because you're going to have stress in a relationship. Almost certainly. And seeing how someone behaves under stress and how they react to you under stress, and especially your feelings about a stressful situation and vice versa for their own experience, is really valuable.
Mm-hmm. It's okay. I am too.
The guests are arriving in 2 minutes and the cake still isn't here.
Everything is gonna be okay, dear.
I know. It's just, I want our day to be perfect, you know?
It will be, because you and I will be married by the end of it, and I don't know why I'm suddenly caretaking a lot. Again, like, I'm a high schooler that I know of. I'm like 18 to 19 years old, canonically, maybe 17 to 19.
Mm-hmm. And I'm taking care of you, and I really want to get married at 17 to
apparently.
19.
No, what I wanted was to go out on dates or fall in love. Well, that just means clearly you have to have, you know, get married.
So I was going to say, it suggests a certain upbringing for the ME if if they really are focused on marriage at this young age when they're still in high school.
Right.
And, like, I would tend to say there's probably a Christian background there, or at least a family with, quote, traditional values.
Right.
Inspired by such a thing. Otherwise, marriage isn't usually the goal at all. And I like you pointing out the established age of this character, because that makes a big difference. Mm-hmm. Like, if this were a 30-year-old individual or somebody who was, like, 26 in their life, where that's the range where you should be getting married kind of thing, them going, hey, I finally met someone, I should be getting married, that's the progression of a good relationship, makes more sense than a kid.
It's true. And it's not to say that, like, for example, like, the boomer generation had a lot of people, and there are still people who are millennials, or even, I guess, now some zoomers. Mm. I'm not exactly sure how old zoomers are right now, so you'll excuse me. But zennials, as they're also said. There's even that idea that many of them also got married, like, almost immediately out of high school. Like, there has been some of those stories, and I remember some of, like, the people that I knew who would actually actively complain, going, my parents keep shitting on me, you know, going, oh my god, you shouldn't be getting married this early. And it's like, you were married at my age around now, and then they're like, well, that's not, like,
different.
It's always a good thing.
I was gonna say, and the thing is, like, it's more in relation to, if you will, again, a particular set of values. Kids, young people don't come up with on their own that marriage is the end goal.
Yeah.
It has to be socialized into them.
Yeah, absolutely. Mm. Because you and I will be married by the end of it.
Aww.
I leaned over and kissed Sketchy. Now go put yourself together, huh? I'll greet a guest and then I'll meet you under the archway.
Okay. Thanks. See you there.
I could see our first guest arriving in the distance. I walked over to greet them, only to find a face I hadn't seen in a long time.
Hey.
Oh, hey, in a long time no see.
Yeah, I figured I'd leave you two lovebirds alone for a while. Got the wedding invitation, though. Thanks.
I mean, that's a long while. Are you implying, actually, that it's been, like, decades?
Or it's been the months, because we've been dating, you know, for months.
Yeah, so...
Not decades.
I don't know. I'm just throwing it out there.
Weeks years! And months went by.
A long month. I know.
It didn't say years.
A long while.
Yeah.
Hmm. Are you gonna make this weird? Why are you making this weird? I mean, I'm glad you came. Why am I acting awkward? Maybe because you're acting awkward.
Yeah, well, I felt I had to. I set you up, after all. I mean, there's something I need you to know before you get married. What you asked me all those months ago? I know I never gave a straight answer, but... I have always had feelings for you, right from the start. The moment you put pen to paper, I have had them. And I've been an asshole to you because of them, which is a real shitty thing to do. I mean,
I won't talk about that because that would probably, you know.
That's
why too direct.
I brought you here to begin with. When you drew me all those years ago, idly doodling while staring at your teacher, I felt a special bond with you.
Is this supposed to be your teacher? What?
Maybe.
I mean, because idly doodling while staring at your teacher, like, that is way too much, like, focus.
For idly doodling while staring at your teacher going, I'm miming pay attention to the lecture, but I'm doing this instead. It could also be that one.
I would laugh, though, if this was your teacher.
I also think it's really funny going, while staring at your teacher going, can you draw without looking at it? Because I can't.
That's what I said. I'm like, what?
And not while looking at your teacher, while listening to your teacher. It's while staring, which is a focused activity.
So we're saying M.E. has hots for teacher.
Could be. Ever since I knew I had to bring you here so I could tell you how I felt. And then I didn't. At all.
I see. So if I may ask, why did you have me draw sketchy then? Why encourage me to date someone else? Like, weird question here.
I'm not sure. I suppose that when I asked you to draw your dream date, some part of me was hoping that you'd draw me. What happens if you do draw them? What happens? Because someone somewhere being a troll would go, I'm gonna draw another Claire.
I don't think you can.
Well, you can't draw it exactly like that.
No, I'm saying, like, I don't think you can, no matter what. Because the drawing is already done. Every drawing is an individual experience. Mm. You cannot draw the same drawing.
Right, but what I mean is, what if you try to model your love interest sketchy after Claire, and for the best of your pencils, doodles, ability,
no, no, no.
Draw
I get your
Claire.
Point. I'm just saying, like, but I also don't think it's literally possible, because you're literally also a different person. Like, at that point, when you drew me at
you
this
You obviously
time,
can't draw them with the same emotions and thoughts, but you could draw them visually, and going, I was hoping
I mean, I
you'd
could
draw,
trace.
Again, I was hoping you'd draw me, and going, can the game interact with if someone draws Claire?
I think that would be hilarious if you could. Like, I do get your point. I'm just saying, like, I literally... Like, there is a sort of, like, philosophical question of...
Yes.
Even if you were going to trace the same drawing, is that drawing or is that just copying?
Is it possible to draw the same drawing again? And if... Okay, but Claire, if we did draw you, my dear, I need to ask, what would you then do with a second version of yourself with four expressions?
Yeah, no kidding.
That maybe... Just maybe you'd felt our bond all this time, too.
No, honey, I have no idea who the hell you are.
Also, if you already exist and drawing creates something new, why would you want us to draw something? Because it would create another you.
Hang on, that actually offers a really bizarre question.
Would it not create another her?
Are we marrying four different sketchies?
That's what I was gonna say.
Like, hang the fuck on.
Because we, this is
like,
one drawing of Claire.
Who and only Claire, changes somehow faces.
I was gonna say, and Claire can emote, but we, but the ME only drew Claire one way, and then Claire created their own emotes. We drew four completely separate sketchies to make the sketchy experience. We didn't draw one that came up with its own expressions.
Oh, wow, that is an interesting philosophical question. Hang on.
We're dating four sketchies.
We did.
We're marrying
and we
four
are.
Sketchies.
Shit, dude.
All right, but when you drew sketchy, I couldn't bear to try and take you away from the newfound love you had created for yourself. I guess what I'm trying to say is, I love you.
That's sweet, but at this point, yeah, I'm especially, like, based on at least our character and how much our character anyway hasn't been interested.
Our character has been extremely enthusiastic about Sketchy.
Yeah.
Like, the character has continued to add their own lines of, I am into Sketchy, I am thinking about Sketchy, I propose to Sketchy.
It's also, like, again, your character really hasn't mentioned Claire in any amount of romantic light at all.
The amount of extrapolation you would have to do to say, no, we're actually into Claire, because of going, the fact that we haven't mentioned her or thought of her at all is just repressing. We're super sundary. We just don't, in your own head, no.
No.
In your own head, you've never thought about her to deliberately not think about her. That's still an action.
That's yeah, that's
yeah, no, you're in love with Sketchy.
I love Sketchy. That's sweet.
Don't say anything back. My heart can't take it either way. I'm not here to crash a wedding. That's not who I am. Hands. You have tiny little hands.
Little hands.
Teeny little hands. I just needed to be honest with you. This is just something I had to do for myself.
Well, neat. Because Claire can do this for themselves.
In the next one.
I appreciate, like, honestly, that Claire is doing this for themselves. Mm. But I'm also just kind of like, I don't know how to take this, because honestly, emotionally, the only thing I have is basically the game going, and now you developed your relationship with Sketchy. And that's it, because we don't really have a connection with Claire at all, player-wise, let alone really character-wise.
I also have a very strong experience here of going, again, how does this work? If we drew one picture of Claire, and Claire is complex and has created their own tiny hands, representative of our skill at the time, even though we didn't draw them.
Right.
I would just say, and expressions, but then had us draw four different expressions to create Sketchy, did Claire somehow assemble Sketchy, the Sketchies, into a being and has creation powers of her own? Did we create four that are behaving as one? And part of the reason Sketchy's so volatile is because it's literally four personalities and only one of them can show up at once to face on the page.
Huh. I genuinely don't know. But anyway, we will have more questions. So if you want to like, comment, or subscribe to share your feelings in regards to what you think about this, because this is interesting, but I'm getting the feeling that the game doesn't really want to go that hard. Like, it's brought up interesting questions.
Like, it's brought up a lot of questions that I doubt it's going to address, but I am interested anyways.
Yes! So, thank you very much, everybody, for joining us. If you'd like to support us, please feel free to go check out our Ko-Fi and our Patreon. We have some links in the description down below. Please also feel free to go check us out on Twitch. We do stream games live at least 3 times a week, if we can. Also, other than that, I have been Scandal.
And I have been Lies.
And it was great playing with you.
Bye!